I was in Detroit recently reporting on rebuilding efforts there. I also recorded another chapter in the series I'm doing with poet laureate Natasha Trethewey that we call Where Poetry Lives. Our goal, to explore poetry and literature in various corners of American life, seeking to connect these trips to aspects of Natasha's personal experience. Here's what we found in Detroit.
Poetry is your wife or husband going everywhere you go, sleeping with you even.
Poetry lives on your doorstep like a baby in a basket waiting for a new family.
Middle school students at the Marcus Garvey Academy in Detroit, reciting the work they'd just written.
With the place that poetry lives.
Teacher and poet Peter Marcus often prompts the students with a question. Today he worked off our theme, asking, where does poetry live?
Poems live in stars, waiting to be wished on.
It's part of an 18-year-old program called InsideOut that sends professional writers into Detroit schools. This year, some 25 writers into 27 schools. When Natasha Trethewey and I arrived at Marcus Garvey recently, she recalled her own introduction to poetry in the third grade.
I was writing poetry, and my teacher and the librarian of the school took a group of my poems and bound them and put them in the school library.
Published poet.
At third grade.
These questions that I ask you, is there only one right answer? No.
Inside Out also turns its students into published poets, part of creating a sense of authorship and voice that Peter Marcus says the program aims for.
Number one, I want to build confidence with a pencil in the hand. A lot of times I can just tell that early on a child doesn't like to write or feels, I don't know what a poem is. And then as soon as I can, I want to sort of disable them from that kind of thinking and saying, sure you can. You just wrote a poem.
Marcus is unafraid to bring in sophisticated works by major poets. On our visit, for example, he used a poem by W.S. Merwin.
We know that our pencils are more than just pencils. There's words hiding inside them. Remember that poem? What are the words doing inside Merwin's poem?
They're waiting to be written.
The program, of course, can't be separated from the city, the very troubled city in which it operates. The shrinking of Detroit's population and its financial crisis have led to the closing of more than 100 schools. And while there are some signs of growth and building in Detroit these days, areas of tremendous blight and poverty remain, including in the area around Marcus Garvey.
Good afternoon, fifth graders.
James Hearn is the school's principal.
The neighborhood is a highly poverty environment, single parent home, really a lot of crime.
So what's the school become then?
It becomes the haven.
It becomes
an oasis in the desert.
Okay, guys, looking real good.
One thing Principal Hearn never imagined as part of all this was poetry. He says he was flabbergasted when Inside Out first came to him.
It was unbelievable. We have so many needs with our kids, and to have poetry as an opportunity, I thought to myself, like, wait a minute, what poetry?
Did you know much about poetry yourself?
Oh, no, not at all, very little about it. But when I saw the kids produced a book at the end of this particular experience, and they could take it home, and the pride those kids had, that was outstanding, you know? So that really won me over.
What do you see them getting out of it?
The love of writing. This poetry really get them truly motivated and excited. And I'm talking about my football players, my athletes, my basketball players want poetry.
Really?
Really.
You're saying that smiling. You're surprised.
I'm surprised. I mean, you know, it's stunning.
Natasha and I had the chance to talk to three of the children after their class, 12-year-old Eddie Stewart and Quentin Pope, and 11-year-old Ricky Porter.
So it sounds like, because you're writing from memory, you're also writing about your experiences.
Yes.
What kinds of things have you written about?
The things I wrote about was when I was in kindergarten, about when it was my birthday, and I cried on my birthday. I wrote about embarrassing times. I wrote about funny times. I wrote about a lot of things that happened.
Mm-hmm. I don't really think it's hard to write poems like this. Really, you just let your imagination run free, and you just write.
Well, it just comes out.
Yes, that's my way of saying it. I didn't like to write before this class, but I've learned that it's okay to express personal stuff when you write. So that's why I started to like poetry. And I like this class because I don't usually write, and this gives me a lot of free time to do what I like to do.
Yeah.
And I love to write.
Quentin told us he wanted to make sure each line is a deep thought.
The deep thoughts that I put in my poems are not about me. It's about that what affects everybody else, just not me.
What kind of things?
I'll say, my poem is a monster scaring you till the lights are on. Someone had been scared or had a nightmare before and turned the lights on and thought someone was there or here.
That ever happened to you?
Yeah.
Afterwards, I asked Natasha what had struck her most.
It was a sense of power that they have from being able to imagine and to create, to name themselves, to speak for themselves. It did really remind me of being in my school and learning poets, the work of poets, African-American poets, that I've carried with me since then. I carried it with me particularly when I was bused later on into a white school when I was in the eighth grade. One of the poems that stuck with me was Langston Hughes's I Too Sing America. And going to that school where people didn't exactly want us, I could be armed with that poem, I Too Sing America. And it was sort of like a force field around me.
You saw that, a little bit of that here today.
I saw a lot of that today.
Terry Blackhawk, a writer and former teacher who founded Inside Out, says evaluations of the program have documented improved writing skills by participants. And she also sees a large civic role.
We're trying to revive our city, not just in the cultural center, but neighborhood by neighborhood. And I think that every school needs a poet, because this poet can help the school, the children give voice to their lives, and you can also build connections in the community at large. So we have parent writing workshops. We have ways of bringing the community into the school.
Welcome to my city. Beauty isn't obvious, but anger beats at our front doors like police giving a last warning.
That night, Inside Out held a public reading that featured several of its alumni, including Justin Rogers, now a student at Wayne State. His poem, Small Town City, was a portrait in words of the plight of his hometown.
I am one of the faithful citizens, rooted like flagpoles, writing love poems to my city, no matter how many dark alleys I tread through or potholes that I almost swim in.
I was trying to touch on really specific situations that people encounter on a regular basis. I looked at what my city is now and realized I enjoy what I have here more than what my fantasy city is, and that these negative things, they are there, but there are so many other positive things that I'm going to enjoy what I have here.
Perez, you're good?
It was a positive moment in a city that can use them, led by poetry, bringing, as young Quentin Pope had put it, the deep thoughts from the inside out.
Online, we have much more, including a poet's notebook from Natasha Trethewey and video of Inside Out alumni reciting their work.